This is a 2013. This is a 2013 Scion TC, and I got it for free. And my neighbors are looking at me like I'm fucking crazy because I'm out here trying to make this video like a fucking moron in my neighborhood. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Do It With, trying to make this video before it rains here. And I have something kind of fucking weird here for you guys. So this is a 2013 Scion TC, right? You guys actually might if you've been following me for a long time, you might actually recognize this car. This belonged to a roommate of mine. He's no longer my roommate. He has since, you know, he's moved out. He's got his own house and his own family and kids and whatnot. Congratulations. But this is his car. This was his 2013 Scion TC. And, he doesn't want it anymore, so he gave it to me, which is fucking crazy. Like, he literally was like, hey, do you want it? And I was like, yeah. And he's like, come and get it. So I was like, okay, so I did. So I have a Scion TC now. Don't worry, I'm not taking from the poor. He's a literal millionaire. He bought this car before he was a millionaire, so humble beginnings. He's like, you can do whatever you want with it. Like, seriously, don't give a fuck. And I was like, okay, awesome, that's great. So honestly, the car, I know it looks rough from the video you guys are seeing right now, but it's actually in pretty good condition. It just looks really dirty. It's been sitting underneath like a tarp, you know? It's had a tarp covered it, and for some reason, it looks like this. I thought tarps were supposed to prevent it from getting dirty, but clearly that's not the case here. So what does that mean for me, right? Like, fuck, I have a Scion TC, a car that I never thought that I would have. Necessarily because I don't like them, it's just not a car that I've ever considered owning. But now I have one. And it's great because it kind of fits in a couple of needs. Some of you guys know that I actually sold my little red pickup truck, and I'm gonna make a video about that. I did sell the red pickup truck. Like I said, I'll go into details later. This thing actually is kind of fucking cool, as much as I hate to admit it. I mean, you know, overall, not bad condition, not bad condition. It's been in an accident or two. Actually, it's been in two accidents, and it has some repair work done, and it is also in need of some repair work. It's got under 100,000 miles. It's like 89,000 miles, which is actually pretty fucking sweet. It's a good deal. So that actually begs the question, what the fuck am I gonna do with this thing? Fuck. So I've had a bunch of ideas, right? So I'm gonna run them by you guys. Obviously, I've had a ton of fucking ideas. My original thought was to turn it into a truck, right? Like, chop it from here back, turn it into a truck, you know, like, put a little wall up in there so it's not open and don't get rained on, so I can haul stuff around in it, and it would be the first Scion TC truck ever. But then I got to thinking, like, actually, I don't want to do that, because it sure would be nice for me to have a car and not rip it apart and then never put it back together. It'd be nice to just do something simple to it, right? So I think, and you guys can tell me what you think in the comments, but I think what I want to do is just do a very chill and simple add-ons build. No crazy engine work. I'm talking like some wheels and tires, a little bit of low, maybe like an air ride suspension, some music upgrades like a subwoofer and some side speakers, maybe better radio, even though it already has a pretty cool radio in it, maybe like flared fenders or like a body kit, you know, like a straight up like Need for Speed Fast and the Furious build. It's no 240SX, even though it makes about the same horsepower as one did. Is it fast? Fucking no, not even a little bit. It is actually pretty fun to fucking drive, I'm not gonna lie. I drove it yesterday, I drove it home, and the interior is fucking massive. It's like sitting inside of like a 4Runner. If you've ever had like a 2016 4Runner, those generation of 4Runners, the inside of it is like just like that. You have so much fucking room, and the seats are so square and buckety. It's kind of a neat little car, like, I'm not gonna lie. It doesn't have a trunk, right? Not a traditional trunk. It's a hatch, which is actually, in my opinion, way cooler. This whole thing, you can lay this thing down. You can fit a bunch of shit in here. This is actually great. This is gonna be perfect for me transporting my signs and other items to and from the shop. It works out. I also told him that if he would like it back when I'm done with it, I'll offer him the ability to buy it back with all the stuff that's on it. If he just pays for that, charge him a crazy amount or nothing crazy like that. Cause that'd be fucked up, right? You give me a car and then I make you pay double what it's worth. That's fucked. If I do upgrades to it and he doesn't think it's cool, then we can like sell it or do a giveaway, or I'll keep it. Like, I don't fucking know. But I'm open-minded. I'm open-minded to what you guys think that the proper mods should be. I definitely want underglow. I don't care what anybody says, this car is getting underglow, because I think underglow is fucking cool. I'm not gonna put it on the Corvette, but I'll put it on this fucking thing. Good, just doing my thing. Don't get me wrong, it does need some TLC. The seats aren't in the best condition. It needs a really good cleaning, but there's no like rips or tears. The seats, there's a little bit of burn holes from the previous owner, not my friend. He doesn't smoke. Needs, like I said, a good cleaning, a good detailing, but You know, I mean, it's a special edition one. The release series, I don't know what that fucking means. But 89,000 on the clock. It's got folding back seats. That's really cool. And really, the only damage is on this fender here. There's a good bit of, I'm sorry, rear quarter. It's dented in from about here. You guys can probably see. So it probably needs some dent pulls, maybe a new quarter. Thankfully, I've got some good body guys who can fix this. If not, I can probably do it myself. This is the fun part. This is where you come in. This is where you're like, where am I involved in this? You're involved. You guys get to decide what the license plate says. You guys get to say exactly what it says, but there are rules. The rules are it's gotta be 7 letters at most, because that's what you can put on the state in Georgia anyway. You're allowed up to 1 space. We live by a train also. Yep. Yeah. Oh, we're good. Cool. So the state of Georgia, you can only have 7 letters. I don't know if it's different for other states. I just know that's what it is. So 7 letter maximum. You're allowed up to 1 space. I think that also counts as a character, so choose wisely. And it's gotta be within reason. Like, I can't put the word fuck on the license plate. They won't let that. Georgia won't do that. They probably also won't let me use the word cum. I'll take whatever the most liked comments are. It can be fucking weird. I don't care. But it has to have the 7 letters, up to 1 space. Doesn't have to have a space, but you can have a space. And it's got to be something that can pass through the state government. So within reason, within reason, you guys get to decide what goes on this thing. This sweet Scion TC. Don't make it awful. Even if it's like super wild, even if you guys vote on something that's like super offensive and wild, I'll give it a shot and see if that works. But if not, we'll go from there. Look in the comments and see if there's anything that you think is funny. Thumbs that one up. And if not, post your own and see if other people think that's funny. All right, that's the end of this. That's this. Thanks for watching.
And before we end the video, I gotta talk about today's sponsor, which is Bucked Up Energy Drink. I've locked myself inside of my hot car on a 98 degree day wearing a sweater so I can prove that all those children and dogs are just a bunch of weaklings. With things like Bucked Up Energy Drink, you can be the strongest version of yourself without having to drink a bunch of energy drinks to feel the energy. That's what I call bucked up. I vow that I won't leave this hot car until you tried Bucked Up Energy Drink using the coupon code DOITDAN, which will save you 20% off their entire website. Please buy some, it's very hot in here. Trust me, Bucked Up Energy Drink will make you feel like a man, or whatever your definition of a man is. It's hot. And the great thing about Bucked Up Energy Drink is that it's available in Walmart, GNC, and select gas stations. But if you use my coupon code, which is in the description, code DOITDAN at checkout, and you'll save 20% of all Bucked Up Energy Drink, which comes in amazing flavors like Breezy Blast or Gummy Deer or Holy Shit It's Hot in Here. Make sure you guys like and subscribe and check out Bucked Up Energy Drinks. I'm close to passing out. It is very hot in here. Seriously, I don't know how all those babies and dogs do it. Thanks for watching, and also thank you for Bucked Up Energy Drink for sponsoring today's video. Get bucked up.